about who I'm calling. I'm pretty sure I know who I'm calling. So if you're going to call me, introduce yourself first. That's how we talk to other humans as individuals. You don't call somebody and then ask who you're calling. And then also wildly mispronounce the actual name of the person you are calling. So let's start over. My name is David. What is your name?
Thank you, David. My name is Julian. Thank you for taking my call.
All right. I appreciate that. Let's start over. What can I do for you?
Thank you so
Did
much,
you just
David.
Burp?
The reason for this... What was that?
Never mind. Continue.
The reason for my call today, sir, is just we were Googling for computer repair service in the area. We came across your page. We see that you guys are highly rated, but we noticed that you have 4 reviews only, okay? I would like to
On
ask
what
you,
service?
Do you consider Google Business?
Okay.
You still with me, David?
I'm here.
All right. Yeah, we were Googling, and we saw your page. We see that you guys are highly rated, as I said. You asked what service. It was computer repair service, and we noticed that you have 4 reviews only at the moment, okay? So I would like to ask you, do you consider reviews not important for your customers?
Reviews are always important.
All right. Okay. Right now we have this software called Nice Job.
Can you spell that? I didn't understand that.
Yeah, that we are calling from Nice Job, by the way, and this is a recorded line also.
Oh no, it's I'm not worried about it being recorded. I didn't understand the brand or the product. You said it. You're from a company.
Okay.
And it sounded like
yes, called Nice Job.
Yeah, you keep saying nice job. Can you spell it? I don't understand it.
Yeah, instead of good, nice job. NICEJOB. Nice job.
Okay, it is not. Okay, I heard you correctly. Continue,
right.
Sorry.
Okay. So, this software is AI integrated, and it's guaranteed to get you 4 times more reviews from customers.
What is AI?
It's going to move you up on Google Run. Go ahead.
What is AI?
Artificial intelligence. I mean, it's completely automated, okay? It's a simple piece of software that is going to collect 4 times more reviews from customers. It's going to provide more exposure to your business. And definitely, it's just going to add some value to your
Okay. I like the idea of added value. How can I use that?
All right. Right now we have 2 weeks free trial. Okay. Actually my job is not to sell you anything at all right now. My job is actually to connect you to bring one of our product experts so he can just go ahead and provide more detail regarding your software.
Okay. You can transfer me. Actually, that sounds interesting.
Just give me 1 second, David. I'm just going to connect one of our product experts right now. If they don't pick up right away, I put you on an ASAP call.
Oh, no. I need them to pick up right away, though. My time is relatively limited. And I appreciate that you reached out to me, but if you reached out to me, then I would have to assume that somebody is capable of talking to me, yes?
Yes. Actually, that's who I am. But my job is to connect you with one of our product experts, okay?
Okay, go ahead and connect me. I am standing by.
All right. Give me 1 sec. You're going to hear some ringing. I'm just transferring right now.
Are you going to do a cold transfer or a hot transfer?
What was that again?
A cold transfer or a hot transfer? Sounds like a hot transfer.
Hot transfer.
Yeah. I like it. Yeah, being transferred without the person hanging on the line is a little rough. But I appreciate you hanging out with me.
I don't want to put you on hold. I don't want to leave you there. Okay.
Okay.
Your time is pretty valuable.
You said you're going to put me on hold or not going to put me on hold?
No. I didn't put you on hold. I didn't want to leave you there hanging, okay?
Okay.
So I just hang up. I just hang up the transfer line. I mean, I can just put you on an ASAP call, and you're going to be hearing from Nigel right away, no more than 2 minutes. Are you okay with that? Can you hang out with me for those 2 minutes? Say that again, David.
Can you hang out with me for those 2 minutes?
No, not really, because I mean, I can try to
please
connect you once again with me on the line, and once we get connected, I just leave the phone call, and you stay with the product expert. But I cannot stay with you on the ASAP call. That's not possible through the system that
it's not possible. Okay. All right, well, I will stay put, and I appreciate you doing so.
All right. Thank you, David. Thank you for your time. I'm just going to put you on an ASAP call then. And remember, this was
an ASAP show. Are you saying ASAP call? What are you I'm sorry, I'm not trying to be obnoxious.
When I say ASAP call, it's just as soon as possible call.
Once the
expert is available, he just call you right away. Probably they're busy at the moment.
I don't want to be called back. I just want to be transferred.
All right. So stay please on the line. Thank you. Just give me, I'm just going to dial with you. In the line, I'm going to be here. You're going to hear some ringing, okay? Let's try this one more time.
Okay.
Just stay with me, please, David.
I'm here.
Thank you. Yeah, that's the thing. It's pretty unfortunate for us and for you as well, because it seems that they're not picking up right now. Busy right now. I have to apologize for that. I mean, the other thing that I can do, because you don't want to get transferred, is just put an appointment call, and they call it back tomorrow morning if you want, tomorrow afternoon. It depends on the time that is best for you, and they call you from Nice Job. I provide all the details.
Pump the brakes, Chief. You cold called me and weren't prepared for me to actually listen to your sales pitch, and now the people that you're gonna transfer me to are too busy to talk to me?
Not too busy, maybe they are.
It sounds like they're literally too busy.
Well, yeah, it seems like, yeah, but that wasn't a sales call. Not sir.
This was because not a sales call. Oh, Jesus, where's my hair?
As I said before, my job is just to transfer you to the product expert.
Yeah, but you didn't do that. I need to talk to the product expert.
Yep.
But that's not happening.
So he can go ahead and provide you. All right, yeah, well, is that okay?
It's not okay. Well, I agreed to talk to you, and there was going to be a product expert who is going to tell me about what I could utilize within your givings, but now you're telling me that you called me and now I can't talk to the person that was supposed to talk to me?
Yes, I mean, we can try it again, if you don't mind.
Please, yeah, go ahead, ring him up again.
Yes. All right, absolutely.
Hello, this is Michelle from Nissan.
Michelle, thank you so much. David, right now you're with Michelle. You're in great hands. Thank you so much for your patience. Okay, now you are being connected.
Hello, Michelle.
Hi, David. How are you today?
I am amazing. Not just how I'm doing. Like, I genuinely, as a person, am amazing. What can I do for what can I do for you? I don't know what your service is. I was called by the previous gentleman that transferred me to you, and now I'm sort of in a lurch. I don't know if I'm using that word correctly. What can I do for you?
David, as my colleague would have mentioned, we have an AI integration that's guaranteed to get you way more reviews and move up on the Google search results as well. So my job is super simple. It's just to make sure this is going to work for you.
Your job is super simple.
We should time with a free trial if it's... Sorry, what was that?
You said your job was super simple. That was... maybe I just spoke out of turn. It was an interesting thing to suggest just... Never mind. Continue. Sorry.
Okay, no, you're good. So I was just saying that my job is just to make sure this is going to work for you. There is a free trial, but I'm not going to waste your time with a free trial if it's not going to be a good thing in the first place, okay?
Okay.
So what I'll do is just ask you a few questions to see how we can help, and if we can help, then we'll definitely get you signed up.
So
get you on board.
Your coworker didn't really give me a full explanation of what the product was. It sounded vaguely interesting, and I'm kind of on board. I was totally Googling something like this not the other day, and it's like as if almost the algorithm connected us. It was super strange. Can you explain, I think, what did they say? Like I'm five. Explain like I'm five. What is the thing again? The service, the product.
Before I definitely do get into that, may I ask, how many years have you been operating for, David?
That is a solid question. I have been doing it, since I was a child, 35 years.
35, so it's Brad's current one, right?
Yeah.
Current one, because it's been 35 years with that business?
Yes, ma'am. It's ma'am, right? I should ask your pronouns. I'm sorry. Was I correct?
Sorry, what was that, David? You cut off.
Oh, no, I said yes, ma'am, and then I corrected myself, and I wasn't certain if I was using the correct pronouns.
You're fine. So are you doing any collect reviews, David?
Collect reviews?
Yeah, are you doing anything like that? Are you asking them?
I'm actually not familiar with the terminology of collect reviews.
So are you asking customers, if I did a good job, would you mind leaving me?
Ooh. Oh, like, have I been requesting people leave reviews on my various, like, social media platforms or whatever? No, I don't traditionally proactively ask people to review me, no. Should I?
Mm-hmm.
I should.
Well, it's definitely a good idea, and we definitely do that as well. So, David, I want you to imagine for a second that you had a tool. For every time, let's say you finish repairing a computer, it would send your customer an automatic message. And it would say something like, hey, Michelle, if you loved her one computer, would you mind leaving us a quick review? Thanks, really appreciate it. So the customer clicks that link, and that link is a smart link. So it already knows what apps your customers are using most on their phones, like Google, Yelp, or Facebook. Let's say they're mostly using Google because, you know, people tend to search everything up on Google. So they click Google, and it automatically opens up to your Google business page straight to the review section so they can leave a review instantly. So it just takes 5 taps, and just like that, in 10 seconds, you've captured a review. So David, with that in mind, how often would we review so we made it that easy for them to do so?
I guess I don't understand the question. Okay, so I'm going to have an interaction with a customer, and we'll give it some sort of cool, like, unique word, like a shorthand version of how I interact with a customer. Oh, I can't come up with anything. I thought I was going to be really clever there for a second. Damn it. My fault. So then I have a CusCom. I'm going to call it a CusCom. It's a customer communication. So I've got a CusCom, and at the end of that, I have to ask them to leave me a review. I don't do that, I think, ever. That might be the problem, why I only have, how many reviews on Google?
I see you have 4 reviews.
Oh, okay. And how do I get more?
Okay, so yeah, so basically how we do it is how you get more reviews. So, do you want me to explain it to you one more time, how we do
that? Yes, please.
Did you listen to that part, or did you hear that?
No, please. As granularly as possible.
Okay, perfect. So, let's imagine I'm one of your customers, okay? And I need one of my computers fixed, okay?
Is it a laptop or a desktop computer?
I need your help.
Is it a laptop or a desktop computer?
Let's just say it's a laptop, okay?
All right.
And
is the,
you know, you, I give it to you, and
what's the issue with the laptop? Is it charging or not charging, or is it like a login issue?
So let's say when I charge it, like the battery lasts like 2 hours. Let's just say that, okay?
That's actually pretty
and
good.
So you tell me like how you're gonna fix it.
I wouldn't tell you how to fix it. 2 hours is actually pretty decent for a laptop battery.
Oh, it is?
Yeah, well, depending on how old it is.
Well, let's say I have a Core i5. Is that good?
Yeah. There's i3, i5, i7, and then an i9. But only just this year they're changing it. And they don't have numbers anymore. The next, next year, there's no numbers.
Got it. Well, let's say, then, I don't really know too much about computers, but let's say it's not turning on, even when I, like, plug it in, or even when I turn the button.
If it's a Microsoft Surface, you can actually press the power button 10 times. And then on the 10th time, you hold it down, and then it will actually do, like, a hard reboot.
Uh-huh.
Just fun fact.
Well,
it's not terribly fun. It is a fact, but its level of entertainment is disputable.
Let's say I give you the computer and you fix my problem and I'm happy with it and I'm back on it and I love it. So computer, let's say I'm like working and then I get a text message and it says, "Hey Michelle, if you love Kerwin computer, would you mind leaving us a quick review?"
Kerwin.
And you know, I'm like, of course, Kerwin, right?
Yes.
Kerwin.
Yes.
I'm just going to say, hey, Michelle, if you love Kerwin Computer, would you mind leaving us a quick review? So, you know, I'm obviously satisfied with the work you did with my computer. So I'm obviously going to click that link.
Obviously.
And this link is going to direct me to your Google Business page, okay?
Okay.
So then I'm going to leave a 5-star review. So if we made it that easy, it just takes 10 seconds for your customers to
do that. I thought they only used 4 stars.
So obviously your customers would leave a review.
Did they... Is it 5 stars? I thought they did 4... Is it not 4 stars?
It's 5 stars.
Okay.
Mm-hmm. So if we made it that easy, just in 10 seconds, they could give you that review. How often would we leave a review?
Well... I would assume you, I apologize, I don't want to sound condescending or anything, but I would assume that you would know what that sort of return time is. I actually honestly don't. I fix computers, but I don't, running a business is, well, hard.
Well, I mean, it just depends how many customers you've had, and I mean, you haven't asked them reviews before, so I don't know if you like you could really tell if they would make it. But normally, what business owners tell me is yes, if it's by eating wood for them to leave a review, then yes, of course they would be more than happy to leave a review. That's what they normally told me. Tell me.
Who's they? You said they tell you. Who's they?
Sorry, what was that, David?
You said they normally tell you.
Yeah, some of the business owners I...
Victims?
Yes, some business owners I talk with.
Business owners. Okay, I heard something different. Sorry.
Yes. Oh, no. Some business owners I talk with, they usually tell me 100% of the time they must leave a review because if it were that easy, then yes. They would be more than happy to.
Some of the business owners tell you 100% of the time.
Sorry, what?
No, I heard something. It just kind of tickled my brain. You said some of the business owners tell you 100% of the time. And then I started going into like a little statistics hole in my... brain. It just I apologize. Continue.
Yeah, of course. You're fine. So let's say a customer doesn't leave a review, maybe it's because they forget to leave a review, maybe they're just too busy to even leave one. So what we'll do is we'll follow up with them with just a few emails over, you know, the next week and a half, so they do have the opportunity to leave you that advice. It definitely show off the good work you're doing. Now, David, are you using a CRM currently or any other software, maybe for invoicing like QuickBooks, Square, Stripe, or PayPal?
That is actually a good question. So you say CRM. I've heard of that terminology, but I don't know what that means.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, CRM stands for Customer Relationship Management.
So what is that?
So yeah, it's some businesses have it, some businesses don't. It's basically a way to keep track of your customers' information and a way to invoice them as well, a simpler way.
So CRM, I keep track of my customers.
Like an organized way to keep your data, your insights, all that good stuff. Of your customer's information.
And it's organized. Got it. Okay.
Do you have a CRM?
Well, I have Outlook. Is that a CRM?
I mean, if you use Excel sheet or Word sheet or Google sheet.
I'm sorry. I don't want to talk over you. What is a word sheet?
Oh,
Yeah.
Or like a spreadsheet.
No, you said word sheet. I didn't know. I didn't understand what that meant.
So it's just like a Google sheet, like an Excel sheet.
Oh, okay. Like, yeah, like.
It has like columns, and you can put their customer's name.
Okay. Yeah. I get it.
Okay. So, do you normally collect your customers' phone numbers or their emails?
Neither. I'm actually kind of bad at that. I think that might be why you guys called me.
So you mostly keep your customers' phone numbers and their emails?
I have, like, my, invoicing program that just, like, that's where their names and information goes, so that when somebody owes me money, I know who to ask for my money.
And do you know what the invoicing software is called?
It's Quicken or QuickBooks.
Okay, awesome. Do you know if it's online or a desktop version?
Online. Everything's online. I don't try to put anything on my computer. Because when my computer, if my computer dies, and then I lose all my invoices, like, that's a nightmare. And it's funny because I'm the computer guy, and I fix people's computers, but if my computer dies, then I can't fix anyone else's computers.
Gotcha. So we are partnered with QuickBooks, so as soon as you invoice that customer, they're going to be getting that text message I told you about earlier.
Oh, awesome.
David, do you know how Google ranks their search results, or do you have an idea on how that works?
I do not know how Google ranks their search results.
Okay, that is totally fine. So Google's a search company.
Well, I would assume it's fine. It's not exactly technically up to you to determine how whether or not I deem something fine. Sorry, go ahead.
Of course. So like I was saying, they're a search company. They do the best job they can to show their customers exactly what they're looking for. And for this to happen, they would need to know two things. Number one, what are you? Well, that's easy to figure out. They can scrape the internet
a white man
and your website and any other sites you're mentioned on. So they know what you are and exactly what it is you do. And number two, they need to know, where does everyone go for this right now? What's the best place to point them? So here's the thing, David. Would you believe that 9 out of 10 people say they trust online reviews more than friends and family?
No.
Okay. So, this is true, and people do say that. They rather trust online reviews more than their own friends and family.
Can you text me a link to that data?
Sorry, what was that?
You said that that's not true, and so presumably there is a link to said data as to the thing that you just claimed. Do you have proof of that?
I'm sure there definitely is.
I would assume that you're sure of it. Can you send it to me? You found me.
I don't have that link right now, but I could definitely find it later.
Do you know who it was through? I can Google it myself.
No, I don't. But, I mean, I personally, when I search, when I'm on Amazon or anything, and I'm not 100% sure the product is as the description reads, you know, I tend to read the reviews.
What was the claim again? 9 out of 10, what?
It was asking if, would you people say they trust online reviews more than friends and family?
Yeah, but you said, a factual statement, but, like, where is the backing? I'm sorry. I know this sounds very potentially aggressive and silly, but I'm very much the opposite. I'm so paranoid about having like a bibliography and sources for things. If you could source that and send that to me, I can never really agree to something without having the proper source. Please continue. I don't expect it this. I don't expect it this. Obviously, this very moment. But uh-huh. if you could send that to me when we're done here, or when it is yep. most convenient for you.
Yes, definitely, of course. So, David, with that being said, what do you think Google does when you have a perfect 5-star rating and have 10 times more reviews than your competition? Where do you think Google's going to place you in the search results?
I'm going to think that they're going to artificially put me towards the top.
Yes, you're 100% correct, David. And with Facebook, it's a bit similar. When people review on Facebook, their whole entire network too, they might do a great review. And it's just like word of mouth, the only difference is in all my version. So it's on a way bigger scale, so you have more visibility for people that search as computer repair services near me. But before I get into that, I definitely want to show you how we can generate referrals as well, okay?
Bring it.
So let's say you got that review and it's 5 stars. That's the kind of review you'd want people to see, right?
Yes.
Definitely. So imagine, let's say you wanted to get referrals for every customer who left you a 5-star review. So you do the work for them, you invoice them, they get that text, they tap Google, tap 5 stars, and they hit submit. Then they would be getting another text message. Seems to be like, thanks so much for leaving us a great review. Would you recommend us to a friend or family member? And David, just like we made it easy for your customers to leave a review in the first place, we make it just as easy for them to refer your business. Now, can you think of a better time to ask for a referral than immediately after a customer leaves you a 5-star review?
I could not.
That would be perfect timing, right?
It sounds like that would probably be the best, not the best timing, the only timing.
Yeah, you're correct. So, David, not only will you get a ton of fresh 5-star reviews and help you move up on Google, but we'll also help you get those nice organic referrals as well. Now, David, do you have a Facebook page for your business?
What does organic referral mean?
Organic, so they're like from your own customer base. So they're not fake. They're all real.
Well, that's not technically the definition of organic, I thought.
Well, they're authentic referrals.
Let's say authentic then. Organic, I think, means something else.
Okay.
I realize as I'm telling you that, I sound like I'm being kind of an obnoxious... Never mind. Sorry. I apologize.
No, you're fine. Don't worry. So as I was asking, do you have a Facebook page or any of the social media for your business?
Yeah. I've actually been on Facebook, probably 20 years.
Awesome. And David, do you have employees or is it just you?
I like to run as like a solo operation.
Gotcha. Perfect. So we also do connect with Facebook. So let's say I am one of your customers and I leave you that 5-star review, okay? So the software is going to detect that 5-star review and it's going to automatically post that review for you on your Facebook page. So you don't have to worry about
Somebody's gonna leave me a 5-star review and your software posts it on Facebook? Where did they leave the 5-star review to begin with?
On your Google Business page.
So your software posts my Google reviews on Facebook?
Yes, because, you know, some customers don't really use Google that much, or some customers, you know, mostly use Facebook. So they'll be able to see...
Well, if they mostly use Facebook and they don't use Google, then why would I need a software that posts my Google reviews to Facebook?
People can see the good work you're doing, so they can trust
it. No, I understand what a positive review is. I'm not retarded. If most people don't use Google and they post on Facebook, and your software posts Google reviews automatically to Facebook, why do I need your software?
Well, I did mention we do have the follow-up campaign as well as the referral campaign. So it just makes it simpler for your customers to leave a review. So that way, one, you know, you can show off the good work you're doing, and two, you can be higher up in the ranks of Google search results.
And so I can get the artificially inflated, like, top of the search charts situation that we talked about? Oh, okay.
Yes, correct.
I like it. That actually sounds...
So, David.
Yeah, I'm sorry.
It takes 10 minutes for me to set up your account, but before I do that, I want to go over the prices and offers I have for you, okay?
Yes, please tell me what the cost is.
Awesome. So, the product itself is $75 per month. Now, there is no setup fee, no onboarding fees, and no cost checks with us, okay? Now, we do have that 2-week free trial, like my colleague would have mentioned, but I actually have another offer. Since you do have QuickBooks and we are partnered with them, if you sign up with me, you get 50% off your first 3 months. So it'd be $37.50 per month for your first 3 months. Now, David, whether you go with the free trial or the 50% off, there is still no commitment and a contract. And with the 50% off, you're protected from that guarantee. Because, you know, at the end of the day, it's about what works best for you and your business. So, David, with that in mind, do you want to stick with the 2-week free trial or go straight with the 50% off for 3 months?
I don't know. It seems like I still haven't properly understood the product. I have very few monthly expenses, so I definitely have more allowance in the monthly marketing budget, but I don't truly understand the product, and I'm sorry. I know you did the best you can, but what's the generic spiel again, if you can run through it.
Okay. Yeah, so basically our point is to basically simplify the leaving a review process.
I don't think you can say basically twice in one sentence. Well, you're actually allowed to do whatever you want. I'm not the cops, but like... Sorry, go ahead.
Okay. So, yeah, so we basically simplify the process of leaving a review, so it's easy for your customers to leave them, and it's way easier for you to just focus on your main job, which, you know, fixing computers, so you don't have to...
My new job?
...for your customers to leave reviews, and they don't need to remember one.
Do you say my new job?
Your main job.
I mean, I just do one job.
And that's the business right you have?
Yep.
So yeah, that's the whole point. So you can just focus on fixing computers and you don't have to ask your customers to leave reviews. It's just an automated process. So, you know, they leave a 5-star review, it goes on your Google Business page, Then after they do leave the 5-star review, we also ask them to refer your business. So not only will you get, you know, those reviews, but you're also going to get those referrals as well.
Okay.
Yes, clients help grow your business as well. So what I'm going to do right now is I'm going to send you a 3-minute product demo that's more like visual.
Is it like a YouTube?
I learn and I like to see things.
Is it a YouTube?
And what's a good email for you, David, that I can send?
Well, you guys called me. You don't have my contact info? My email, I'm not sure what the email, because people...
Oh, I do see her one right here. Oh, I found it. Don't worry.
I wasn't worried.
So I will send the information to your email.
Don't.
Sorry, what was that?
I said don't.
Oh, you don't want me to send you an email?
Yeah, I'd rather not.
Okay, so it's just a way for you to see about the product, and it also has the customer testimony videos, as well as customer success charts as well. All the good stuff that you can, you know, have a look at the company as well.
What videos?
Yeah, I just typed it to you at this number right here.
I'm sorry, I didn't understand the word before videos.
Yeah, I just texted it to you on this number.
Texted it?
Yeah, I texted it to you.
Texted it.
Yeah, I texted it.
Oh, okay, cool.
Yeah, so when is a good time I could do a follow call with you, David?
That is a good question. The person I talked to before you, are they available? Cold? What does cold call mean?
Well, it's basically a call where businesses really don't know much about, you know, what they're calling about. So what we do is Google businesses around, like, that area they're in, and we just call those numbers. So basically, it's like a call. You're not really sure what the call is about. So that's why it's a cold call.
So I didn't request this phone call. At what point, let's see here, we're at 43 minutes. At what point are you going to realize that I'm messing with you?
Well, that's a good question. Well, you did sound really interested, though.
I'm a pretty good actor. Like, I've been screwing with you.
I gave you props.
I've been screwing with you this whole time. And I don't know at what point, like, when you were going to hang up on me. And so now the fact that you are still on the line, I have to give you props, I guess? Damn.
I'm a very nice person. I don't like being rude to people. I'm very patient.
No, you wouldn't have a cold calling job if you weren't a really rude person. You gotta get a different job, bro. Like, this is, it's too much. You are nice. I don't want to, like, insult you and call you names. I assume in this kind of line of work, you probably get called names all the time, and that's obviously inappropriate, but like this, you can't be doing this. Like, well, technically, depending on what they're paying you, I would do it all day long, especially because I have the ability to bullshit people, clearly, as I've proven. But are you okay with this job?
Actually, this is only, I've been working here for like 6 months. This is the second call I've gotten that, like, you know, they mess around with me. But I don't know, I'm a very patient person.
God, you might be the most perfect human being, like, for these jobs. Like, they're super, it's just a click and a hang up, or you have, you, how many sales have you made? I know that's kind of a wild question. I wouldn't expect you to technically answer that, but, like, have you made sales doing this job?
Of course, yes, to a lot of business owners.
Wow! Can I have that list? Because those people are gullible as shit. You have my email. You have my email, right? You have my email, right?
Yes, I do.
Can you send me the list of people you've made sales to?
Oh, that I can do.
Aww. Like, aww.
I don't
aww.
You want me sharing your information to other people, right?
Actually, if you gave my information to other people, that would be amazing, because that's called free advertising, and people want free advertising. So I'm going to say to you, oh. Okay. So you called me from a 206 number. Are you actually in the 206 area code, or are you from, like, mobile?
No, we use automated dialers.
What is an automated dialer?
Is that an actual question?
Oh, yeah, no, that's a genuine question. I honestly don't know. I was screwing with you earlier, but now I'm actually curious.
Okay. Well, it's just like, it's literally just a phone that keeps calling businesses, and it gets the area code they live in.
Oh, so, like, your physical location has nothing to do with the phone number you're calling from and the ID on my screen?
Mm-hmm. No.
Oh, that's actually...
It's just
that's,
way so we can get better in touch with our customers.
That's genuinely interesting. Can you tell whoever the powers that be that we get a lot of these phone numbers in the Seattle area, which is the 206 number, we get a lot of people, and it calls the iPhone specifically says what area the number is coming from, and 206 is in the quote-unquote Seattle area, but it actually comes from, like, Bainbridge Island. So in the northwest corner of Washington State, there's the same area code, but it's made out of a bunch of islands. And so traditionally, people do not receive phone calls. This is actually something that would benefit you getting a better call answer response rate, is that in the northwest part of Washington State, all of the 206 numbers come through as 206, but the iPhone says Bainbridge Island or San Juan Islands. It's kind of like the islands around where the vampire movies. all the weird, goofy areas of Washington, you have to take a ferry to get to. So it seems like your company is buying phone numbers, but they come from the islands. And when that comes up on the phone, most people don't answer the phone because nobody knows anybody from the islands. So just kind of a fun fact, and possibly something your manager could utilize.
Yeah, that's what you're talking about. I used to live in Washington.
Yeah, so you're familiar with the islands. So your phone number, it's the 206 is Seattle.
Yeah, especially Mercer Island.
Mercer, well, that's different because that's in the middle of Lake Washington.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, I've been there a few times. I actually live in Redmond.
Okay. What part of Redmond?
Mm-hmm. I live close to Redmond High School.
That's funny because that's where I live.
That's where I went to high school. Oh, really?
Are you serious? Because I live in Redmond.
First I lived in DuPont, then I moved to Redmond.
Yeah, I live...
as well as RTC, Redmond Town Center.
I live right... I'm looking at Anderson Park.
Yeah,
I literally live...
South Carolina.
Yeah, I live literally next door to Anderson Park. Like with the
Oh my god,
the log cabins.
There's a skate park. There's also a skate park.
Yeah, the skate park right next to the transit center. Literally right next to where all the buses are. And you're not here anymore?
No, I moved to South Carolina.
That's crazy.
Yeah, it is. Who knew? Well, David, it was a pleasure speaking with you today, David.
Was it? Was it really?
Yes, even though
you
were, like, messing around with me, but it's okay.
All right. You got to hang up on me first because that was my goal, and we've been talking for about an hour.
Okay. Well, have a nice day, David.
Okay, you too.
Thank you. Bye-bye.
Okay, bye. You gotta hang up first. I'm not hanging up. That's the deal. You literally have to hang up. I'm not gonna hang up. You have to hang up. Hit the button. Do it. I know you can hear me. Hang up. Hit the button. She's not gonna hit the button, is she? Hit the button. Hang up on me. Look at this. Look at this. What is this? I'm never hanging up. I don't care. I'm going to... Well, first I'm going to throw up, apparently, in my mouth. I'm going to charge the phone. And then, eventually, she's probably going to hang up. Hang up! You have to hang up the phone. I'm not going to hang up. You hang up. can't stop recording if she doesn't hang up. Alright, the end of this video is not going to be very good, but she hasn't hung up yet, and so I don't understand. I mean, I do understand. I know that she's not going to hang up. They're not supposed to, but goddamn, hang up the phone! Oh, is this how she gets me? Because I screwed with her, she's going to screw with me? That's actually pretty genius. I'm not even mad. Touche. High five. Oh, shit. I'm walking away, but I'm not hanging up. I'm not giving up. Never give up. Don't stop. Never stopping. Never hung up, so I guess I have to hang up. They have some sort of policy. Look at this. They have like a policy that we can't hang up unless you hang up first, which is a weird policy because we aren't supposed to do XYZ, but we will get away with murder by being like a predatory bullshit company. Everything's stupid. Nothing matters. And Jesus, where's the rest of my hair? Oh no. You know what? I don't really care. You know what? Fuck you. I look good. Maybe. Ah, 58 minutes and 4 seconds. Can I ride this out to an hour? No. Do I want it over an hour or less than an hour? Does that give me more views? I don't understand how YouTube works. I'm gonna probably upload this to YouTube. Oh no, I recorded this vertically. Fuck! Alright, I fucked up. Sorry, everybody. I'm gonna go just deal with it. Look at that fucking cord placement. I'm bad at everything. I'm sorry. Funny ending quote quip about the government or something. Sorry. Shit. Fuck. 58. Oh, no. 59. Okay. Bye. Oh, wait. I forgot to look. I have to look at the camera. Don't look at yourself in videos, by the way. Look at the camera. And not look at the video. Don't look at your own eyes like some sort of autistic whatever. Look at the camera. And then when somebody asks you how you're doing, answer the question. Don't ignore it. Damn it. Everything's stupid. Now I'm gonna ride this out for 25 more seconds because I need 1 hour of video. I feel like 1 hour of video is good. Oh my god, I'm looking at myself again. Okay, look at the camera. I'm looking at the camera. 59, 50, 51, 52, 50. I yelled at that lady for 50 minutes? That poor lady. All right, that's 1 hour. Okay, we're done. Oh my God, my ears are clicking. Clicking is not good, right? Bye. I need like a closing joke. The government. Sorry.